Hello everyone. In this session, we are going to learn about feedback amplifier concept. Learning outcome of this session, at the end of this session, students will be able to understand a basic feedback amplifier concept and types of feedbacks. So these are the contents of this session. So introduction to feedback amplifier. Now let us start with the basic definition of a feedback amplifier. And what is a feedback? Feedback is defined as the process in which a portion of output signal, some portion of output signal of amplifier is fed back to the input side of amplifier to produce effective input signal for amplifier. So that is used to control the output signal of amplifier and many characteristics of amplifier. So in a feedback amplifier, the output quantity, either voltage signal or current signal, so that is sampled by means of suitable sampling network, and it is fed back to the input side of amplifier using feedback network. So output of feedback network, so that is a fraction of output signal, a signal proportional to the signal sampled from output of amplifier. So that is combined with the external signal, that is externally applied signal source signal, so through a mixer network, and applied into the basic amplifier. So after mixing of feedback signal with the externally applied input signal source, the effective input signal is applied to a basic amplifier. Now let us go for conceptual development through block diagrams. The block diagram of a basic feedback amplifier consists of five basic elements. These basic elements of a feedback amplifier are input signal source, comparator or a mixer network at the input side of a basic amplifier. Then the third component is a basic amplifier, then a sampling network, and finally the feedback circuit. Now this figure shows a block diagram of basic feedback amplifier. So it consists of a basic amplifier. So at the input side of this basic amplifier, there is an input signal source, so that is connected with the mixer network or a comparator, so to which the feedback circuit is connected. The feedback circuit is connected in between the output of basic amplifier and the input of basic amplifier. So using a comparator or a mixer network. So for a mixer network, one of the input is from input signal source, that is externally applied, and another signal from a feedback circuit. So feedback circuit takes some part of output signal, either a voltage signal or current signal, using a sampler or a sampling network, and it is fed back to the input side of amplifier. So here Vin is the effective input voltage of a basic amplifier, and In is the effective input current of a basic amplifier, whose voltage gain is designated as A or AV, and I is the output current, and V is the output voltage of a basic amplifier. And after a sampling network or a sampling network, so output load resistance RL is connected. So voltage appearing across load resistor RL, so that is the amplified output voltage of this overall amplifier V out, and current flowing through this load RL, so that is output current of amplifier, that is equal to a load current. So output of basic amplifier is fed back to the input side of basic amplifier using a feedback circuit or feedback network. So VF stands for the output voltage of feedback circuit, and IF stands for the output current of a feedback circuit. The input for feedback circuit is the output voltage of a basic amplifier, that is V out, and the forward transfer ratio or gain of this feedback circuit, also called as a feedback factor, so that is designated as a beta. So beta stands for the gain of a feedback circuit. So this figure shows a basic feedback amplifier block diagram. Now let us discuss each block of this block diagram one by one, starting from input signal source. input signal source which provides either voltage Vs or current Is. The signal source is either a voltage source Vs or in series with its internal resistance Rs, or a current source whose output current is Is, that is in parallel with its internal resistance Rs. And second component element of this feedback amplifier, that is a comparator or a mixer network. The two networks used for mixing of the input signal from input signal source and the feedback signal coming from the feedback circuit. So that is shown in figure 2. The circuit shown in figure 2A is a series connection, and it is used to mix the signal voltage Vs and the feedback signal voltage Vf from feedback circuit. So the resultant of Vs, input signal voltage Vs, and feedback voltage Vf is Vi or Vin, that is applied to a basic amplifier. Shunt connection, now another possibility for a mixer network or comparator. So that is that uses a shunt connection or parallel connection. So that is shown in figure 2B, in which the source current Is, in which source current Is and feedback current If from feedback circuit are mixed. And the resultant of this Is and If, that is the effective input current II, is applied to basic amplifier. So this figure 2 shows a series connection at the input side of basic amplifier, in which the output voltage of feedback circuit, that is Vf, so it is combined or mixed with the voltage from external signal source Vs. It is applied in series. So Vs are effective input voltage of a basic amplifier, and the voltage signal from feedback circuit are coming in series. So there is a series connection at the input side of a basic amplifier whenever a voltage signal that is proportional to output quantity is applied in series with the input signal of amplifier. Now the second figure shows whenever the output of feedback circuit is a current signal IF, so that is proportional to the quantity sampled at the output of amplifier, so it is applied in parallel or in shunt with the input current from input signal source Is, and the effective input current for amplifier II is a resultant of IF and Is. So basic amplifier, next element of this feedback amplifier is a basic amplifier. The basic amplifier is the most important part of a feedback amplifier. This circuit amplifies the effective input signal, either a voltage signal or current signal, so that results from a comparison or mixing in the mixer network to control the output signal. So basic amplifier amplifies the effective input signal and provides output voltage or a current signal, so that is controlled by means of the effective input signal. Now next element of feedback amplifier, that is a sampling network. The sampling network are of two types, similar to mixer network, namely voltage sampling and current sampling. So depending upon the type of electrical quantity taken from output of basic amplifier, so there are two types of sampling networks. One is voltage sampling, another is current sampling. So as shown in figure 3A, the output voltage is sampled, and part of output voltage is taken, and the output port of feedback network sampled and the output port of the feedback network. So in figure 3B, the output current is sampled. The part of output current of a basic amplifier is sampled, and the output port of a feedback network is connected in series with load. So whereas in case of voltage sampling, so output voltage is sampled, and output input port of feedback circuit, it is coming in parallel with load resistor RL. For current sampling, the output load resistance is coming in series with the input port of a feedback circuit. So this is called as a current sampling. Now this figure 3, A and B shows the voltage sampling and current sampling at the output of basic amplifier. So for voltage sampling, the output voltage is taken from the basic amplifier output and it is given to the feedback circuit. So there is a parallel connection or shunt connection. So the input side of feedback network and load are coming in parallel, as far as whenever current is sampled from the output of basic amplifier, the load RL and the input side of feedback network are coming in a series. Now next element of feedback amplifier, that is a feedback circuit. The feedback network or feedback circuit is generally a passive two-port network and consists of resistor, inductor, and capacitors. Mostly in amplifier, the feedback network or feedback circuit consists of resistors. Its function is to transfer a signal that is proportional to part of output electrical quantity, either voltage or current signal, back to the input side of amplifier. Now let us go for the expression for a gain of a feedback amplifier. So considering the voltage amplifier, let the voltage gain of basic amplifier is AV, and overall voltage gain of feedback amplifier is designated as AVF, and beta stands for feedback factor or gain of feedback circuit, and VF is output voltage of feedback circuit, and VS is external input voltage. So Vout is the final output voltage of overall amplifier. So from block diagram, the effective input of amplifier Vin, so that is equal to VS plus VF. For VF, we can write VF equal to beta, that is beta is nothing but a feedback factor, not a current gain of transistor in common emitter circuit configuration. So VF equal to beta into Vout, and so Vin equal to VS plus beta into Vout, and Vout equal to AV into Vin. So after simplification, Vout equal to AV, voltage gain of basic amplifier, multiplied by external input voltage VS plus beta multiplied by AV into Vout. So after simplification, so we are getting the expression for voltage gain for overall feedback amplifier. So that is a ratio of final output voltage to externally applied input voltage VS. So that is equal to AV upon 1 minus beta AV. So voltage gain, overall voltage gain of feedback amplifier designated as AVF. So that is equal to AV, that is the voltage gain of basic amplifier, divided by 1 minus beta AV. So basically there are two types of feedbacks, positive feedback and negative feedback. So in case of positive feedback, both effective input voltage of amplifier and feedback voltage are in phase, and feedback factor is positive. So gain with feedback for a positive feedback amplifier, AVF equal to AV upon 1 minus beta into AV. Now for positive feedback, voltage gain with feedback is greater than voltage gain without feedback. So positive or regenerative feedback, in which the overall gain of amplifier is increased, a positive feedback, it is always used in oscillators. The second type of feedback is a negative feedback. In negative feedback, the input voltage signal and the feedback voltage signal are out of phase by 180 degree. They are of opposite polarity. So feedback factor is negative. So gain of overall amplifier with feedback, AVF, is equal to AV upon 1 plus beta AV. So in this case, the overall voltage gain of this negative feedback amplifier is less than voltage gain of basic amplifier, so that is without feedback. So negative feedback is used in amplifier to make operating point of a transistor insensitive to both manufacturing variations as well as surrounding temperature. Now student can pause video here and think over this question and try to answer this question. Which type of feedback is used in oscillator circuit and why? So the type of feedback used in oscillator circuit is a positive feedback, because positive feedback increases the effective input signal of an amplifier. So this positive feedback is useful in increasing the strength of initial input signal of the amplifier. So that is required in oscillator circuits. So this is a reference. Thank you.